All right, well, let's take it to a guy who can maybe help out with these Carolina Panthers offensive line problems, which is the tight end they drafted, Ian Thomas. Saw him out there throwing some good blocks. Looked like he had some pretty soft hands. What did you guys see from Ian Thomas?
Well, this is was my favorite shot after the big kind of couple of tight ends coming off of your draft board and your rookie drafts here. I think Ian Thomas is, as advertised, at least as far as I think, what he can bring to this Panthers team. They're just, everything they're talking about is the work ethic and everything he puts in at practice, and he's really smart and he knows where to be. He knows how to run routes. He knows how to sit down in zones. He knows how to operate on the field and, you know, move left or move right as opposed to where the zone is kind of setting up. And he, I thought he had a pretty good game when he was out there. They were doing nothing but praising him. He's definitely my favorite tight end shot after the Mark Andrews and the Goederts and the Hayden Hurst come off the board. I like the Ian Thomas, and it was nice to see him show up in this game and here. And then the Roto World blurb, I think the day after the game, was giving him even more love. So,
yeah, I mean, you said he was as advertised, but you were the one doing the advertising back in the day. We put out that podcast about the later round stabs, and like you said, after those bigger names tight ends, it was Ian Thomas for you. We'll get to Jordan Akins later. That was my guy, but Ian Thomas is more than advertised, really. And they ask Greg Olsen, who's been the star of the, who's been the person that made the biggest impression on him throughout camp so far, and he said Ian Thomas.
Yeah.
Obviously, they're two tight ends, so maybe they're sitting in the same room together, right. But to go back on what you're saying, Ian Thomas is where they're supposed to be, and every single thing out of the Panthers on Ian Thomas has been positive. And some of that, you just got to say, coach speak, coach speak, coach speak, coach speak. But after a while, where there's smoke, there's fire. He comes out. He looks good in this game. He's doing what he's supposed to do. So at this point, Ian Thomas has got to be on your radar. Obviously, later on, and we're talking dynasty here, so we Ian Thomas and there's somebody you want to look at. Greg Olsen's got a two-year contract, but he could be in the booth next
year.
He's
old and has a foot. And
he's got a foot problem. And
Ian Thomas, and like we've mentioned, Norv's been a guy who has produced tight end stats over the years. And Ian Thomas can give you a little bit of everything. He can make a big play. He can take it the distance. He's got plenty of speed. He can catch. He can block.
Yeah, he sprung some runs and then had that little bobble against the sideline. It was a nice route that he ran to get open and then just bobble a little bit. It took him forever to review that freaking play. It was annoying, but
the preseason reviews killed me.
Yeah, but I mean, he's there making plays and he looked good. So I thought that was definitely worth mentioning. All right, well, this team played the Bills. We're going to take it over to that side, but first we're going to take a quick bathroom break, and we'll be back for your pleasure.